Hello my friends and welcome back to a new video. In this video I'm going to show you how to use row and column, two great features of the Jetpack Compose. So please subscribe to the channel and give me a thumbs up for this video and let's dive in. Here I have the same structure as the previous videos. A composable function named myApp and a preview function, and I have added the composable function here. I have called it actually in the set content, and this is the preview. I have a text, subscribe. What if I have another text? Let's see. And you see these two texts are overlapping on each other. So what if I have another one? And you see that is even worse. So we need a feature to divide them. For this we can use column to divide them vertically and row to divide them horizontally. Let me show you. Without adding any feature to the column, let's locate them inside it. And now you can see that these are arranged vertically. And if I'm changing it to the row, you can see the changes. Yeah, I have all of the text arranged horizontally. We can add some features on the row and column, as you see here. Modifier, as always, horizontal arrangement and vertical alignment. And if I'm changing to the column, you can see it's pretty the same modifier we have, but the arrangement and alignment are reverse. There we had vertical alignment, but here we have vertical arrangement and the horizontal alignment instead of horizontal arrangement. So these are the differences between row and column as well. Let me show you what are these actually. Consider now all of the text are starting from the left edge of the screen, which is the start. We know it as the start, and from the top of the screen. What if I want to see them in the middle of the screen? So here I am going to add a modifier equals to modifier dot fill max size. And now this is my screen size, and the column is expanded in the whole area. And if I want to see the text here in the middle, I can add horizontal alignment and here are the options of the alignment. Now by default is on the start, alignment.start. If I add the alignment.end, the text will go here to the right side. And if I check this one, the text will come here in the middle. Okay. Now we can see the text are here in the middle, but we want them here in the middle of the screen. So we can add the vertical arrangement and then arrangement, and the same we have some other options as well. So I'm going to use this one and then I will show you the rest. Just to know For now, by default, we are setting here arrangement top. And if I'm checking this, you can see the text are located in the middle of the screen. But there is no space between the text. What if I want to manage some spaces between the text and divide them, expand them? We can use the other features of the arrangement. It can be a space evenly, a space around, and a space between. Let's start with a space between. If I select a space between, and you can see that the whole area of the vertical size of the screen will be divided between these texts, just like that. And if I change it to a space evenly, it will be like that. The whole empty area is divided by four parts, one here, and two between the text. And the differences between a space around and a space evenly here. We have now a space around. These two area are the same, and this area are like half of this empty area, just like that. Now what if I change it to row? As you see, I have error here because I told you that in the row and the column, these factors are reverse. So instead of horizontal alignment, now we have horizontal arrangement, and instead of vertical arrangement, we have vertical alignment. So I have to change them. Arrangement and alignment. And let me cut it and paste it here. And let's cut it and paste it here. And this one should be vertical. Now let's see the differences. Okay, the text are expanded in the screen, but horizontally, and you have them here in the middle of the screen. These are the features of the row and the column, and how and why we should use them. So I think that's enough for this video, and I have covered everything about the row and column. So be with me in the next video, and in the next video I'm going to talk about the box. That one is also one of the good features of the Jetpack Compose. It's something like frame layout in the classical Android system. So if you want to see that video, remember to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to be aware about the new video, to have the notification about the new videos. Give me a thumbs up for this video, and you have any comment and question, you can write them down below in the comment box, and I will be so happy to answer them. Thank you very much, and have a good time. Bye bye.